Hello everyone. In this video, we will try to understand and solve one of the Amazon coding interview questions which were asked to me when I was being interviewed by Amazon. Although there were a lot of questions asked in the interview, but in this video, I'm going to talk about one of them. And I will also try to share how I actually approached this problem during my real interview. Also, in the end, we will do a step-by-step code walkthrough of the problem. So the problem which we will talk about in this video is the vertical sum in a binary tree. The problem statement is this way. Given a binary tree, find the vertical sum of the nodes that are in same vertical line. Print all sums through different vertical lines starting from the leftmost vertical line to the rightmost vertical line. If you are not sure what exactly a binary tree is, let me give you some context about it. Binary tree is a tree data structure in which each node has at most two children. That means a node can have no children or one child or two children. Let's see this example. In this example, node 5 has no children, node 17 has one child which is 9, and node 1 has two children which are 5 and 8. If you want to know more about a binary tree in detail, you can check out an amazing video lesson by my code school. I've kept the link in the description. Okay, so let's get back to the problem. Here the first vertical line has node 5. The second vertical line has nodes 1, 17 and 2. The third vertical line has nodes 8 and 9. And the fourth vertical line has node 24. So the vertical sum of the first vertical line is 5 itself, as it has a single node. The vertical sum of the second vertical line is 1 plus 17 plus 2 equals to 20. The vertical sum of the third vertical line is 8 plus 9 equal to 17. And the vertical sum of the fourth vertical line is 24 itself. So the expected output or answer is 5, 20, 17 and 24. I hope the problem statement is clear to you and you understood what exactly is the ask here. When I got this problem in my interview, I was very happy because I had already solved this problem before on Geeks for Geeks. But during the interview, I took a lot of time to understand the problem completely and was asking the interviewer some basic questions like how many nodes can be there in a tree at max, or can a node value be negative, etc. Just to pretend that I have never seen or solved this problem before. This is very important to know, because if you somehow let your interviewer know that you have solved this problem before, then the interview will not give you those many points because they judge you on the basis of your thought process. But if you have already solved it before, then there's no point. Why I'm saying this is because there may be some problems in the interview for which you don't know the solution, and you anyway have to think and use your mind at that time itself for those problems. It is possible that you might not be able to crack them. So it is always better to take advantage of the problems you already know. Okay, so let's discuss the solution to this problem. Firstly, we need to find out the horizontal distance of each node of the tree from the root node. Node with value 1 is the root node in this case. The idea here is, if two nodes have the same horizontal distance, then they are on the same vertical line. For example, nodes with values 1, 17 and 2 have horizontal distance 0. A node with value 5 has a horizontal distance minus 1. Nodes with values 8 and 9 have horizontal distance plus 1. And a node with value 24 has a horizontal distance plus 2. Now you might be wondering how to find out the horizontal distance of a particular node. Let's consider the horizontal distance of the root node to be 0. Now if you move towards the left node, the horizontal distance will be minus 1 of the current horizontal distance. And if you move towards the right node, the horizontal distance will be plus 1 of the current horizontal distance. If you consider the horizontal distance of the root node, which is a node with value 1, to be 0, then if you move towards the left node, which is 5, its horizontal distance will be 0 minus 1 equal to minus 1. Now, there are no nodes further, so we'll move towards the right node, which is 8. Its horizontal distance will be 0 plus 1 equal to plus 1. Now we'll move towards the left node, which is 17. Its horizontal distance will be 1 minus 1 equal equal to 0, and so on and so forth. This way, we can calculate the horizontal distance of each node recursively with the help of any tree traversal algorithm. If you want to know more about the tree traversal algorithms in detail, you can check out another amazing video lesson by my code school. I have kept the link in the description. Now that we know the horizontal distance of each node, we need to store the vertical sums for different horizontal distances with the help of a data structure. So yeah, it's HashMap. HashMap is an associative container that stores elements in a map fashion. Each element has a key value and a map value. And no two map values can have the same key values. So in this problem, it's going to be like HashMap of horizontal distance is equal to HashMap of horizontal distance plus node value. And you can see how we can calculate for the horizontal distance equal to plus 1, which comes out to be 70. So these are the results for horizontal distance minus 1, 0, plus 1, and plus 2, which is the expected output or answer for this problem. Yeah, so here I have taken the same example, and the code for taking the input is already written. As in the interviews as well, you just need to write the main logic part of the code. As you can see, a node is created using the structure. In the main part, we have created the tree, and a function with name vertical underscore sum is called, where we have to write our main logic part of the code. If the root is equal to null, which is our current node, then we don't need to do anything. So we'll just return. Otherwise, we'll go to the left node, then we need to do something here, and then we'll go to the right node. Now let's declare the hash map. In the do something part, we'll add the node value to the hash map of a particular horizontal distance. Also, while going to the left node, horizontal distance minus 1, and while going to the right node, horizontal distance plus 1, we need to pass. Note that I've used the in-order traversal of a binary tree here, but you can use any one. That's it. Let's print the values from the hash map from the beginning to the end using the iterator, which will eventually represent the vertical sum from the leftmost vertical line to the rightmost vertical line. Now we'll run the code. And you can see the output or answer is as expected. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you understood the problem and the solution. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment section down below, and I will be very happy to answer those. Also, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.